And Moshe returned unto the Most High and said, Oh, this people have sinned a great sin and have made them gods of gold. Yet now, if thou wilt forgive their sins, and if not, blot me, I pray thee, out of thy book which thou hast written. And the Most High said unto Moshe, Whosoever have sinned against me, him will I blot out of my book. Israel did the wrong thing more times often than not, by falling after the Hebrew what? And worshiping their gods. As if it ain't already worse enough, some of us refuse to acknowledge. We walk the journey to the Most High, so put it down in this spot. Like it or not, it's an hour, it's a second, it's a moment that he's coming on the watch. Never know what watch that he's coming. So you gotta stay and keep watching. Stay alert at all times with my eyes on the prize and my mind focused on the Most High. Building my treasures up for the King, so I can make it in on time. Cause he's coming like a thief for the night and he's coming for his bride. I shall roll it to a trial. It don't matter if you a part of Israel. If you make the stake and deny Christ, don't try to make the stake about black and white. Listen about truth and lies. We bringing out the truth on hate note and exposing every one of their lies. Isaiah 32, verse 10, the Spirit pouring upon us from on high. I've forgiven us mouth to mouth, bringing us back to life. We like to deck ourselves out and decorate. I'm sending down the Holy Spirit from Shemaiah to help us regulate. We like to deck ourselves out and decorate. But hold up, wait, pump your brakes and blot your name about the book. If you add to it or take away, we like to deck ourselves out and decorate. Deck yourself out and decorate. Often imitated, seldom duplicated. Decked out and yeah, decorate. For you deck yourself out and decorate. Whose character you portray and whose ways do you imitate? Do you follow after your own inclinations? Do you humble yourself down to offer up old blessing? Your walks are balanced, ties, needs, and rotations. Spirit or deck can pinpoint and locate them. I'm gonna say what most of the people they won't say. Deck yourself out and decorate. Celebrate our abomination and idolize it oneself. Over the Most High become a full occupation. Yeah, you decked out. That's an understatement. Like a 5-star general, you decorated. You talking about some reparation when we waiting on our restoration. To tell the truth, I think people sick and tired of it. Brother spitting hard for the truth. But the Father said, be ye steadfast, so I'ma keep on dropping these jewels. I dropped that practice in that witchcraft in that 4th of July. Please, dear family, take heed, for he brought you at the book of life. Now you can turn your ears away if you're helping on doing mischief. But if you plotted out the book, that means you on Yasha's hit list. We'd like to deck yourself out and decorate. Deck yourself out and decorate. I'ma send it down the Holy Spirit from Shemaiah to help us regulate. We'd like to deck yourself out and decorate. But hold up, wait, pump your brakes, then plot your name about the book. If you add to it or take away, we let you deck yourself out and decorate. Deck yourself out and decorate it. Often imitated, seldom duplicated. Decked out and yeah, decorate. We let you deck yourself out in gold. Deck yourself out in pearls. Deck yourself out with all the finer things we receive in the world. And while we're decking ourselves out in the mirror, putting on our clothes, decked out from head to toe. But what about your soul? We be decking out our cars and decking out our homes. We ain't breathed the Holy Spirit long enough. It's time for the demons to go. So the next time you're working out in the gym, my brother poke him eyes when you're sitting on swole. And the next time I sit that you're working in your cardio, looking at the mirror at your curves. It's best for y'all to take heed to this and hearken unto his word. Bodily exercise profit a little bit. Holiness is to save your soul. While we deck ourselves out with jewels and gold, shoes and clothes and say who to know. Then whom is wealth? You unturned your back on the maker and you lost your nerve. While I'm pitching for the side of the curve. Why side on this first shot still being fired on the turn? I'm obliged for the word, cause the Father put his words in my mouth and we know that it's fired with his word. We like to deck ourselves out and decorate. Deck ourselves out and decorate. I'll be sending down the Holy Spirit from Shemaiah to help us regulate. We like to deck ourselves out and decorate. But hold up, wait, pump your brakes and blot your name about the book. If you add to it or take away, we like to deck ourselves out and decorate. Deck ourselves out and decorate. Often imitated, seldom duplicated. Decked out and yeah, decorated. Decked out, yeah, decorated. Highly intelligent and educated, but still don't know what the Father said. But swear up and down that you be praying. You must be playing, or either faking, or one of those agents that come from Satan. But hold up, wait, you might just be one of those that's just too sophisticated. When the Bible says that we have done the Holy Scripture from a child that make us want our salvation. But by the process of elimination, it's either we doped out, drugged out, and spiritually sedated. Then witchcraft is medication. I mean, the medication's witchcraft. Hey, tell me where my ribs at. And I ain't talking baby back, even though you thought I meant that. I'm talking about how we go hard in the faith. Stand in the gap with the armor for the saints. And we fast and we pray, going hard for the king. And it's all in his name, let us all sing his praise. And we be decked out, we be decorated. The Holy Spirit got us decorated. And that's why the whole world hated. Like plan on stopping, I'm like, no way. Grace decked down, we be decorated. Holy Spirit got us operating. Decked out with the fruits of the Holy Spirit. If you know what I'm saying, we be decked down, we be decorated. Holy Spirit got us operating. decked out, we be decorated. Say it with me if you know what I'm saying. We be decked out, we be decorated. Holy Spirit got us operating. Decked out, we be operating with love for the whole congregation. We Israel. We Israel. We Israel. Yeah, family. It's about that time when we get into the second part of this Shabbat jam, which is the lesson for those who ain't got an ear to hear, or you feel like your time, like this is too long, or it's boring, or you just ain't got the patience for it. Go ahead and excuse yourself. There's no love lost, and I invite you to stick around. I mean, but I can't force you, baby. He that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit is saying. Now to the rest of us that's ready to go ahead and get it in and focus and fix our minds on the good word of the Most High and really apply these scriptures and the things that we learn to our everyday walk in real life, real time. We getting ready to get it out that Bible. Matthew 13 and 15. But this people's heart is waxed gross, and their ears are dull of hearing, and their eyes they have closed, lest at any time they should see with their eyes and hear with their ears and should understand with their heart and should be converted and I should heal them. Then why don't we do it? Because our people destroy it for a lack of knowledge. There's something working against this, family. Something that go deep into the root. Remember, man has a duality. Spiritual, the inner man, the soul, and pride springs up and he decks himself out. He rejects the knowledge of the Most High. And the outer, the carnal, fleshly, earthly, and the two continually war against one another. Now the Most High is a spirit, and those who serve him, like me and you, must serve him in spirit and truth. Let's get into this profound and thought-provocative lesson and see if we can get somebody to reconsider before he blots them out the book. Revelations 3 and 2. Be watchful and strengthen the things which remain that are ready to die. For I have not found thy works perfect before the Most High higher. 3. Remember therefore how thou hast received and heard, and hold fast, and repent. If therefore thou shalt not watch, listen, I will come on thee as a thief, and thou shalt not know what hour I will come upon thee, when you least expect it. 5. He that overcometh, the same shall be clothed, endure to the end. White raiment. That's decked out. And I will not blot out his name out of the book of life. Glory to the highest. But I will confess his name to the Lamb before my Father and before his angels. He that hath an ear, let him hear. Are you listening? When the Spirit saith unto the churches. Isaiah 50, 4 through 5. The Most High Ahiah have given me the tongue of the learned, that I should know how to speak a word in season to him that is weary. He wakeneth morning by morning. He wakeneth my ear to hear as the learned. Point in case. The Most High Ahiah have opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. We gotta hear. Neither turned away back. We can't stop our ear at his word. Meaning I didn't lose my nerve from hearing what he said. When others swayed off course, I stayed my part and stayed the course that he charted, so that we might be converted into vessels of righteousness, and then receive the reward of that eternal crown and glorious robe, and put on that new man that's decked out, made after his righteousness, not my own, his likeness. Feel me? Walking just like the Messiah. Come. Looking just like the Messiah. What else? Talking just like the Messiah. Bring it out. Loving just like the Messiah. Get decked out, decorated. But what'd it take to get that? Let's jump down to verses 6. Through 9, I gave my back to the spiders, and my cheeks to them that plucked off the hair. I hid not my face from shame and spitting, for the Most High Ahiah will help me. Therefore shall I not be confounded. Therefore have I set my face like a flint. What that mean? In the Hebrew, H2496, klalamash, which means flint. A rock. In other words, you know how when we go out and try to bring the truth to our peoples and they ain't really trying to hear it? You mean brush you and off? They ignore you? They give you that stout look and turn their shoulder?
Yeah, I used to do the same
thing. Well, we make our face even harder.
That's right.
We know.
Bring it out.
And I know that I shall not be ashamed. Verse 8. He is near that justifieth me. Who will contend with me? Let us stand together. Who is my adversary? Bring it on. Let him come near to me. Behold,
verse 9,
the Most High, a higher will help me. Come. Who is he that shall condemn me? Lo, they all shall wax old as a garment. They thought they was getting decked out and decorated,
like deck out,
but that moth shall eat them up.
Decorate.
Who is among you that feareth the Most High, a higher?
Verse 10,
that obeyeth the voice of his servant.
Bring that out.
That walketh in darkness and have no light.
Blind as a bat.
Let him trust in the name of the Most High, higher.
The law is the lamp.
And stay upon his power.
Feel me?
In other words, if we was blind due to our darkness, the Most High sent the law of life to light up that candlestick, to light your soul up. And you should hear the Wakwadai speaking to you like in Isaiah 30 and 21, telling you, go this way, go that way. Do this, don't do that. But we gotta obey him for this thing to work. Let's get verse 11, Isaiah 50 and 11. Behold, all ye that kindle a fire,
that means
that compass yourselves about with sparks,
with your own works,
walk in the light of your fire,
doing it your way,
and in the sparks that ye have kindled,
this is what you brought about.
This shall ye have of my hand.
Don't expect.
Ye shall lie down in sorrow.
High fives and thumbs up.
In other words, you might be laughing now, you might be decked out right now, but in the end, the wicked gonna see the righteous get decked out.
You listening to me?
And they gonna sorrow and shame, and whimper down and wish and say, oh man, why didn't we listen?
I wish I would.
Why didn't we choose to obey the Most High when it was prophesying and he was correcting and rebuking me with love?
I thought he hated
that I might understand.
I thought he was mad
that our ways is darkness and folly with the Most High.
I couldn't see it then.
Let's get more. Let's jump back over to the book of Revelation chapter 3, starting at verses 8. I know thy works.
He know your labor
and to the extent of how much work you putting in. Whether you're doing it wholeheartedly or just half-stepping and playing. He know who's hot and who's cold and who's lukewarm. Listen at the book. Behold, I have set before thee an open door, and no man can shut it. But thou hast a little strength, and hast kept my word, and hast not denied my name. Verse 9. Behold, I will make them of the synagogue of Satan, which say they are Jews, and are not, but do lie.
Hold it there.
Pause for the cause. We all know that there's people running around here acting as if they the Jews, the biblical Jews of the Bible, or the Yehudim.
Yeah, we know about them.
They cover blown. But what about these other Jews, these other brutes? You know what I mean? Let's get Romans 2 and 28. But he is not a Jew, which is one outwardly carnal. He might be decked out with his fringes. You know what I'm saying? She might be decked out with her head covering, right? He got a beard down to the flow. She got on a dress so long it's out the dome, but still something missing. Neither is that circumcision which is outward in the flesh. Verse 29. But he is a Jew, which is one inwardly. Point in case, the whole thing I've been saying this whole time. And circumcision is that of the heart, in the spirit, and not in the letter, whose praise is not of men, but of the Most High, a higher. See, men, they should have their beards, and women should be modestly dressed in dresses and what have you. But if it's all for a show and to appease a man, and you yet haven't been convicted and offered yourself as a sacrifice to keep the laws and the commandments of the Most High, is our reasonable service. It's the least thing that we can do, dear family. Now, don't get it twisted, thinking that I'm against brothers with beards and sisters that's covered up and dressed modest with long dresses. I'm for that. But about that faking and fabricating holiness? That's N.O.T. Hanley. That's what them fake Jews do. So you can't deck your outer appearance out while your inside looking all toe up and raggedy. Listen back at the book, Revelation 3 and 9. Behold,
I will make them come and worship before thy feet. Same people in Isaiah 50 we was talking about, that set up their own light, and to know that I have loved thee. 10, because thou hast kept the word of my patience,
we didn't turn.
I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation, which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth.
To see who is?
Behold,
and who's not?
I come quickly.
Made on the Most High.
Hold fast which thou hast, that no man take thy crown. He that overcometh,
steadfast,
will I make a pillar in the temple of my God.
That's decked out.
And he shall go no more out. And I will write upon him the name of my God, and the name of the city of my God, which is New Jerusalem, which cometh down out of heaven.
Can you see it?
From my God. And I will write upon him my new name. 13. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says unto the churches. Second Timothy's 4:2-5. Preach the word. Be instant in season, out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all longsuffering and doctrine. 3. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust, that means something forbidden, shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears. 4-5. And they shall turn away their ears from the truth, and shall be turned unto fables. But watch thou in all things, endure afflictions, do the work of an evangelist, make full proof of thy ministry. Selah. Armor up. Romans 8:18-23. For I reckon that the suffering of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. I'm talking decked out and decorated, family. 19. For the earnest expectation of the creature waited for the manifestation of the sons of Ahiah. 20. For the creature was made subjected to vanity, not willingly, but by reason of him who have subjected the same in hope.
Now we got to break that down just a little bit.
Precept, 1 John 3:2. Beloved, now are we the sons of the Most High Ahiah, and it doth not yet appear what we shall be, but we know that when he shall appear, when Yahshua comes, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. In other words, anything that you try to do or put your mind to in this lifetime to achieve without trying to follow the Most High and be the son or daughter of the Most High that he has called you to be, it's going to end bad for you, family. The Most High has set before us all life and death and blessings and curses, and said, choose ye this day. Choose one. Life or death, blessings or curses. See, we've been living the curse. So it's either you obey the Most High and see how you're going to be decked out with a glorified body. That's what we are just speaking on in 1 John 3:2 as the precept. Anybody that don't get a glorified body like Yahshua, they're going to see everything that they strove for was for nothing. It was worthless, irregardless of how lavish that they may have lived in this lifetime, in this platform, in this wicked place that we call home. No, man, I don't know about you, but we look for a new earth and a new heaven wherein righteousness dwells. And we're going to be decked out with a glorified body that's specifically for the new earth and the new heavens. Let's get more on that before we go back to Romans 8 and verses 21-23. 1 Corinthians 15, starting at verses 39. All flesh is not the same flesh, but there is one kind of flesh of men, another flesh of beasts, another of fishes, and another of birds. 40. There are also celestial bodies, meaning the heavenly, and bodies terrestrial, meaning earthly. But the glory of the celestial is one, meaning different in splendor, as opposed to the terrestrial, meaning our earthly bodies, which gets tired, gets worn out, subject to diseases and sicknesses, defecates and urinates. We make excuses and procrastinate. Some of us stay in the congregation of the dead because we reprobates, and it's the Father's law that we violate, and sin we like to tolerate. Well, we should let the Holy Spirit operate. Then we lash out on the Father because of our own idle state, when it's all written and documented in your Bible, man. What you say? 1 Corinthians 15:42. So is the resurrection of the dead. It is sown in corruption.
it is raised in incorruption. It is sown in dishonor, verse 43, it is raised in glory. It is sown in weakness, as I was mentioning, it is raised in power, a glorified body. 44, it is sown a natural body, it is raised a spiritual body. There's a natural body and there's a spiritual body. Point in case, I told you that man has a duality. The natural carnal part of man is that sinful fallen nature of man that needs to be seen as being something prevalent, something exalted, someone that got it all together, a know-it-all, sophisticated, educated, decked out, decorated. But what will you decorate yourself in, dear family? Will you allow the Most High to remake you, shape, break, and mold you into the image of His dear Son? Or will you continue on the path to destruction while you pine away in your sins? Let's read on, 45. And so it is written, the first man, Adam, was made a living soul. The last Adam was made a quickening spirit. Howbeit, that was not first which is spiritual, but that which is natural, and afterward, that which is spiritual. In other words, you had a natural body. Man followed after the inclination of his own mind. The fallen nature of man had to be quickened and made alive by the Son of Man, the Son of the Most High who came down from heaven. And then that man who was quickening had to be raised up into a new spiritual being after the image of the one who has quickened and raised him. Hence, Yeshua the Christ. 1 Corinthians 15, 47 through 54. The first man is of the earth, earthy. The second man is the Lord from heaven. As is the earthy, such are they also that are earthy. And as is the heavenly, such are they also that are heavenly. And as we have borne the image of the earthy, we shall also bear the image of the heavenly. Now this I say, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of Ahiah. Neither doth corruption inherit incorruption. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory.
Deck yourself out, decorate. Deck yourself out, decorate. I was sending down the Holy Spirit from Shemaiah to help us regulate. We like to deck yourself out, decorate. But hold up, wait. Pump your brakes. About your name, about the book. If you add to it or take away, we like to deck yourself out, decorate. Deck yourself out, decorate. Often imitated, seldom duplicated. Decked out, yeah, decorated.
Back to the first premises on Romans 8 and 18 to 23, starting at verse 21. Because the creature itself also shall be delivered from the bondage of corruption into the glorious liberty of the children of the Most High. For we know that the whole creation groaneth and travaileth in pain together until now. 23. And not only they, but ourselves also, which have the first fruits of the Spirit, even we ourselves groan within ourselves, waiting for the adoption, to wit, the redemption of our body. I just want to say the water for you all. Let me into your heart and your home. Hopefully I said something to stimulate thought and to have you proactively look at yourself and begin to go on the offensive of the kingdom of light and take every thought captive to the obedience of Yeshua, casting out every vain imagination and mortify the deeds of the flesh so that you might truly be decked out and decorated with that spiritual body that comes from the Most High. Now we almost done. I only got a few more scriptures before I let you go. Now you know when I say we almost done, I'm long with it. Bear with me. Now I'm just kidding. Maybe about another 3-4 minutes or so, if you can bear with me. While we get it out that
Bible,
make sure that I deck you out and decorate you with this holy word from the Most High. 1 Timothy 4 and 8 says, for bodily exercise profited a little, but godliness means holiness, is profitable unto all things, having promise of the life that now is, and of that which is to come. Precept that with Matthew's chapter 6, verse 19 and 20. Lay not up for yourselves treasures upon earth, wherein moth and rust doth corrupt. And where thieves break through and steal. 20. But lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust doth corrupt, and where thieves do not break in through nor steal. In other words, dear family, remember that. I know we want to be healthy, eat healthy, think healthy, look healthy. But remember the six things that the Most High hates, and the seventh is an abomination, as it speaks to us in the book of Proverbs, chapter 6, verses 16 through 19. And that first one says, a proud look does the Most High hate. So we got to be careful that we don't let the things that we involve ourselves with, or that the things that we do or that we wear, neglect our responsibility from being holy and set apart and devout and devoted unto the Most High. Where we begin to now lift ourselves up and decorate our things, like our cars, our homes, our wardrobes, our toys, wait, ourselves, our motorcycles, you know, and boats, airplanes, vanity, jet skis, ATVs, things like that. St. John 17, starting at verses 14 to 21. I have given them thy word, and the world hath hated them, because they are not of the world, even as I am not of the world. I pray not that thou shouldest take them out of the world, but that thou shouldest keep them from the evil. 16. They are not of the world, and even as I am not of the world, sanctify them through thy truth. Thy word is truth. As thou hast sent me into the world, even so have I sent them into the world. And for their sakes I sanctify myself, that they also might be sanctified through thy truth. Neither pray I for these alone, listen good, but for them also which shall believe on me through their word. 21. That they all may be one, as thou, Father, art in me, and I in thee, that they also may be one in us, that the world may believe that thou hast sent. The book of 2 Baruch, chapter 54, verses 15 through 22. For though Adam first sinned and brought untimely death upon all, yet of those who were born from him, each one of them has prepared for his own soul torment to come. And again, each one of them has chosen for himself glories to come. Speaking about that glorified body, being decked out with decorate. Verse 16. For assuredly, he who believeth will receive reward. But now, as for you, you wicked that now are decked out and decorated, turn you to destruction, because you shall speedily be visited. And that formerly you rejected the understanding of the Most High. 18. For his works have not taught you, nor has the skill of his creation, which is at all times, persuaded you. 19. Adam is therefore not the cause, except only of his own soul. But each of us has been the own Adam of his own soul. But do you, O Most High, expound to me regarding those things which you have revealed to me, and inform me regarding that which I besought you. For at the consummation of the world, vengeance shall be taken upon those who have done wickedness according to their wickedness, and you will glorify the faithful according to their faithfulness. For those who are amongst your own, you rule, and those who sin, you blot out from amongst your own. The book of 2 Ezra, chapter 16, starting at verse 35. Listen now to these things and understand them, you who are the servants of the Most High. This is the word of the Most High. Receive it and do not disbelieve what the Most High says. The calamities draw near and are not delayed. Verse 38. Just as a pregnant woman in the ninth month, when the time of delivery draws near, has great pains around her womb for 2 or 3 hours beforehand. But when the child comes forth from the womb, there will not be a moment's delay. So the calamities will not delay in coming upon the earth, and the world will groan, and pains will seize it on every side. 40. Hear my words, O my people. prepare for battle, and in the midst of the calamities be like strangers on the earth. Let the one who sells be like the one who will flee. Let the one who buys be like the one who will lose. Let the one who does business be like the one who will not make a profit. And let the one who builds a house be like one who will not live in it. Let the one who sows be like the one who will not reap. So also the one who prunes the vines like the one who will not gather the grapes. Those who marry like those who will have no children. And those who do not marry like those who are widowed. Because of this, those who labor,
labor in vain.
For strangers shall gather their fruits and plunder their goods, overthrow their houses and take their children captive. For in captivity and famine, they will produce their children. Those who conduct business do so only to have it plundered. The more they adorn their cities, deck it out, their houses and possessions and their persons
decorated,
the more angry I will be with them for their sins, says the Most High. Just as a respectable, virtuous woman abhors a prostitute, so righteousness shall abhor iniquity when she decks herself out and shall accuse her to her face when she comes. Who will defend the one who searches out every sin on earth?
Every sin on earth. Every sin on earth. Every sin on earth. Every sin on earth.
Isaiah 32, verse 10, the Spirit pouring upon us from on high. I'm forgiving us mouth to mouth, bringing us back to life.
We like to deck ourselves out and decorate. Deck ourselves out and decorate. I'm sending down the Holy Spirit from your mind to help us regulate. We like to deck ourselves out and decorate. But hold up, wait, pump your brakes. You blot your name about the book. If you add to it or take away, we like to deck ourselves out and decorate.
Deck ourselves out and decorate. Often imitated, certain duplicated. Decked out and yet decorate.
We like to deck ourselves out and decorate. Deck yourself out and decorate. I'm sending down the Holy Spirit from your mind to help us regulate. We like to deck yourself out and decorate.
Well, hold up, wait, pump your brakes. You blot your name about the book. If you add to it or take away, we like to deck yourself out and decorate. Deck yourself out and decorate. Often imitated, seven duplicated. Decked out and yet decorate.
And I leave you with this, dear family, to put on your mind. Awake, awake. Put on thy strength, O Zion. Put on thy beautiful garments, O Jerusalem, the holy city. From henceforth, there shall no more come into thee the uncircumcised and the unclean. Precepts, Revelation 21, 10 through 12. And he carried me away in the spirit to a great and high mountain and showed me that great city, the holy Jerusalem, descending out of heaven from the Most High, having the glory of a high, and her light was like unto a stone most precious, even like a jasper stone, clear as crystal, and had a wall great and high, and 12 gates, and at the gates 12 angels, and the names written thereon, which are the names of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel.